friends, welcome to one more interesting aspect of qualities of great organizations. And the topic for today's discussion is well-known company policies. Ladies and gentlemen, there are many organizations in this world, but only those organizations are famous. Those are having well-known company policies. And only because of these great policies, these organizations are well-known and people are willing to work in these organizations. The very first quality is at-will employment. No organization can force you to stay with it without your permission. If you are not willing to work for an employer, if you are not willing to work for an organization, if you are not comfortable working in a particular company, they cannot force you to stay forever. You can leave that organization by serving the designated notice period according to the rules and regulations of the organization. Another crucial aspect is ombudsperson policy. Ladies and gentlemen, the organizations follow this ombudsperson policy. This policy is followed by those organizations who are having no union concept. The place where there are no unions, there we have ombudsperson. If you have problem with anyone inside the organization, you can directly report to ombudsperson. Even if you have any problem with your seniors and superiors and you are not liking their behavior or any other aspect, you can directly report to ombudsperson. Any employee can directly report to ombudsperson inside an organization without any fear. Another crucial quality is internal hiring opportunities. Sometimes it happens that when we join the organization, we join according to the needs and requirements of the organization and according to the qualification that we are having. This is the set pattern of hiring in any organization. But once we spend a certain period of time inside an organization, we start developing interest in some other domains inside the organization. And we have this desire that we want to move into those domains. And organizations certainly give us such opportunities, ladies and gentlemen. There is internal hiring opportunity. Organizations select employees into various other domains within the organization, and every employee is open to apply for any open position inside the organization, irrespective of profile. Another crucial aspect is sexual harassment policy. Ladies and gentlemen, the dignity of a woman must be preserved at any cost, and the organizations who follow sexual harassment policy are certainly the greatest organization. According to this policy, if you are troubling a female employee inside the organization, not only you will be out of the organization, but you will come under legal trouble. A legal case will be filed against you for destroying the dignity of a woman. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a policy not only in organization but in Indian law. And great organizations, in this case, in the case of sexual harassment, they follow all the rules and regulations of Indian Penal Code. So be aware. Regarding this policy, if the dignity of a woman is spoiled in any way, you will be out of job and you will face many other troubles. There is no need to explain, ladies and gentlemen. Another crucial aspect is orientation policy. Whenever an employee joins an organization, he is told about plans and policies of the organization by the people of the organization during the first day visit. We all know about orientation, but orientation is not only limited to explaining you the plans and policies of the organization. Ladies and gentlemen, great organizations have tie-ups with great speakers, great motivational speakers, and great people who have achieved great success in different other domains. And these organizations, they call such people during the first day of orientation, and these people tell employees that what additional things are required along with technical qualification that they are having, to establish their good reputation inside the organization and to consistently grow as a reputed employee. Another crucial policy is absolutely no against drugs. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, if you are an alcoholic person, if you are a drug addict person, organizations will not only throw you out of the company, but again, a legal case will be filed against you for spoiling the dignity of the organization, because no organization can ever accept alcoholic employee and those employees who are under influence of drugs. It's the question of reputation of the organization. And yes, legal case is certainly filed against you, ladies and gentlemen. I am not joking in this case. So these are certain plans and policies of the organizations that make it a great organization. And these plans and policies must be implemented, ladies and gentlemen, because they are ultimately for your benefit, for your betterment, not for the betterment of the organization. That's all for today, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you loved my today's video. Please subscribe my channel, Er.Piyush Pandey, B.Tech MBA, and press the bell icon for constant updates. Thank you very much.